To me, it's a movie, like any other movie, only it has so many better things in it.
Like what?
Like me. It was a really good script and an extraordinary story. I couldn't pass it up. It was a really, such a perfect opportunity to go out of my comfort zone and finally scare myself and do something different.
Tell me about the person you're playing.
Well, at first I'm closed up like a flower.
Mm-hmm.
Bud.
Yeah.
And then gradually the petals start to open, and then I finally learn about myself, and I learn how to enjoy sex.
Beautiful.
I think she was excited just about being the center of attention. I think that that's what I wanted to come across. It is, for someone who wants to be an actor, I mean, this is, for this opportunity to come up, it can't be the worst thing in the world. For her, she was forced into it, but she also got to make a lot of friends, and they treated her really well, and she was, every time she was on set, she was away from her husband couldn't abuse her like he did behind closed doors. So I think she did feel liberated in a way. And she did feel like it was sending a positive message. Deep Throat definitely wasn't the worst experience filming it, but it definitely became the worst thing in her life because it defined her. The violence was definitely the hardest part of the work, because it's not natural to be manhandled. Whether you're doing it for a movie or it's real life, it's just not natural. And it can be scary even though you trust your co-stars. I guess I just kind of let it happen and let it affect me like it was. I mean, this woman, we were depicting what she was trying to express in her books and for the world to hear.
The pornographic film Deep Throat has become one of the most popular and profitable blue movies of all time.
This is a phenomenon.
I think back then it was run by some very dirty, corrupt people, and I think that most of the women that were probably involved were being abused and coerced into it, and I don't think it's the same. I don't think we're dealing, I mean, where there's so much porn now and it's just being made, but it's not being made necessarily by all terrible monstrous men. It's being made, some porn is being made by women for women, and vice versa with, you know, with men. And it's like a healthy place. Because I'm not gonna judge anybody for wanting to watch porn. But when it's violent, I don't think that's okay, and I don't support that. But I certainly support people expressing themselves in the way they feel they need to or want to. She spoke out against violence in porn. She just didn't think that porn was okay. She was a Catholic girl. Really, this woman is religious, and she was the opposite of what everybody projected onto her. Her image did not reflect who she was.
What did you do to make him angry?
I guess I didn't do what he wanted me to.
We're all gonna win Oscars.
I learn how to enjoy sex, and I feel free.
She's coming back to me.